Welcome back to the Cutler Report. President Obama will say he needs a few more years. Those are his words to get America's problems solved. Few more years of what? The same failed policies? You know, polls show no one really believes that this stuff is going to work. For some reason, President Obama wants to stick with the program. It's the same program that has failed. Here now is veteran Democratic strategies to take me on, Robert Shrum, Congressman Nan Hayworth, Republican from New York, and Heather Higgins, President and CEO of the Independent Women's Voice. Okay, I was very surprised. Let me go to you, Heather, first. Bill Clinton last night basically said, okay, it's a bad recession, Obama's done the right thing, and he said essentially no change, just stick with the program. Now, I've seen Democratic pollsters, Republican pollsters say people don't believe this program is going to deliver. Why do you think Clinton said we should wait and apparently Obama's going to say the same thing? Is that going to work?
Because Clinton couldn't possibly say that he needed to change if Obama's going to say he needs to stay the same. I mean, that would be violating the whole purpose of Bill Clinton being there endorsing him. Obama promised us that he would be a one-term president if we didn't see an economic recovery in 3 years. Obviously, that's a promise that has sort of gone by the wayside along with so many others. But the challenge is that you have a man who really has never had any private sector experience, who doesn't really understand how economics works, who believes that you can just operate by central planning fiat and by tiny little incremental measures and doesn't understand the importance of certainty and predictability and long-term planning to real investment, who thinks that government actually makes investments when, in fact, if you knew about investments, you wouldn't be doing it for the government.
You know, Bob Shrum, actually, what our John Harwood reported earlier from excerpts in Obama's speech,
right.
He's going to talk about FDR and experimentation. Now, I don't know what you think of that, but that could mean some changes are coming.
Oh, listen.
When I hear experimentation, I'm not sure what to think,
listen,
but it may be different.
This whole discussion is naive and pre-cooked. The fact is the president's going to go out tonight, and he's going to come up with some bold proposals. He's going to talk about a vision for the country in the future. He's also going to be honest that this mess took a long time to create, and it's going to take some time to come out of it. Look, the last businessman, really big businessman, we had as president was Herbert Hoover. I'm not sure private sector experience is the key to doing this thing right.
Actually, George W. Bush.
Oh, yeah. He was a failed businessman. He had a lot of trouble with the Texas.
Are a great baseball
yeah, he
team.
Bought into it for almost no money, and they just gave gave him the presidency
before
of it.
Before I go to Nick.
By the way, I would also say I wouldn't brag about the Bush economic record because he's the guy who dumped all this. This incredible mess into the lap of the country and Barack
course,
Obama.
Bill Clinton deregulated the banks.
Bill Clinton
deregulated the banks. Bill Clinton ended Glass-Steagall. And Bill Clinton also deregulated Fannie and Freddie and told to make lousy
loans. Actually, it was
now,
George Bush who talked about the ownership society and made them give out all of these subprime mortgages.
Everybody thinks
that was not Bill Clinton. Larry, get your facts
with
right.
With respect, I completely disagree with you. But
how about with facts?
Those are facts.
No, they are not.
Under Bush, they tried very hard to go after Fannie Mae. No, they pushed Fannie Mae to give subprime loans.
That happened under Andrew Cuomo and Bill Clinton.
No, it did not.
You had a Democratic House with Barney Frank saying that it was solvent and you couldn't fix it.
You spin this story out.
Let me go.
You know what's great? I'm sorry I'm talking so much, but
you've
got a real balanced panel here, Larry.
Let me go to Nan. Do you think his argument of 4 more years or 3 more years or whatever is going to work? That was the argument that Clinton made last night, and it seemed like the precursor to Obama's argument. Do you think America is going to vote for a guy who's telling them they've got to wait several more years for economic success?
Americans, based on my experience as representative for the Hudson Valley in New York, Americans are fed up. They are desperate for change, but not the kind of change that President Obama, based on the experience of 4 years of his policies, has provided to us. So they want to see the kind of change that is from economic growth. And when President Clinton spoke last night about his presidency and alluded to the triumphs that happened after 94, 95, when there were some troubles, what he neglected to mention was that the great engine of that economic growth, among others, was the dot-com boom.
Newt Gingrich did it. Go out and tell people that. I'd love to hear. You know what's going to happen in the Hudson Valley? You're going to defend voucher care, and Sean Patrick Maloney is going to stand up for Medicare, and people are going to say they don't want the kind of change you're talking about.
Well, we're really sorry that you want Medicare to go bust.
No, Medicare goes bust. 8 years sooner under Romney, because he takes that $716 billion in savings from insurance companies and gives it right back to those insurance companies.
The thing
companies.
About Bill Clinton's speech, if you remember, there was a show.
You guys really don't like the Clinton speech, do you?
I like the Clinton speech.
It was great as a speech.
Some parts of it I agree with. Some parts of it I disagree. Listen,
it was just really light on facts. It was like the
pandemic.
It was full of facts.
I have praised Clinton. Clinton had some great economic achievements, but he worked with a Republican Congress. That's the key point.
And he also ignored the engine of growth, which was the dot-com boom. And what did that come from, Bob? It came from enterprise. And as far as Medicare goes,
the dot-com boom actually went bust, as you may
know. Bob, the Democratic plan for Medicare is cut and kill Medicare.
No, it is not. That is absolutely wrong. That is a lie. It is a lie you guys keep telling. It's a lie. No, no, excuse me. There is not a single penny cut from Medicare benefits. You want to voucherize Medicare. You're going to cost seniors. You're going to cost seniors hundreds of dollars more a year. They got to go out and
may I ask Heather? May I ask Heather? This is a neutral question, actually. If President Obama does come out with some specifics tonight, all right? In my head, I have this line in the excerpts from the speech that, like FDR, he's going to talk about experimentation. And Shrummy did say in the beginning that he might have some new things to unveil. Here's my question. If he unveils some new specifics, will that put the pressure on Governor Mitt Romney to be more specific about his own economic plan? Because in his convention speech, there was only a couple of hundred words about Romney's economic plan. It disappointed me. It disappointed a lot of people. So can Obama put pressure on Romney to come up with details for his plan?
I would love it if Romney would, because I think that one of the things Romney needs to explain is that, unlike the left, we believe that capital and labor actually go together. We believe that markets are actually the engines of growth, and that we, in fact, are not the Hobbesians that they planned us out as being, but we actually believe that private sector and private voluntary sector is where you find most of your real solutions. In fact, conservatives tend to be consistently more charitable on every measure than liberals do personally, whether it's blood transfusions or donations or time. The challenge with Obama providing specifics is that over the last 3.5 years, whenever he has had a proposal that he lays out, it's in specific-ish, vague terms, and then there is never an actual plan.
All right, well,
there
we'll
is
see.
Never an
it's
actual
it's
anything
it's
to look
absolutely
at.
Wrong.
It is absolutely true.
He has sent job bill after job bill after job bill.
He has only sent things that his own Congress won't vote for.
No, it's not his own Congress. Nan Hayworth and the Republicans in the House have blocked every measure for job creation. You don't have to grab my arm, Nan. You're wrong.
The Democrats won't vote for his own Congress. The House voted zero.
No.
For the president's plan.
No, wait a minute. There is huge Democratic support in both the House and the Senate for the president's jobs bill. Your guy, Mitch McConnell, said the whole aim here was to defeat the president. You care a lot less about the jobs of Americans than you do about getting back the job of president.
We will have you all back. We will have you all back. Explain that to the Hudson Valley, whatever. Bob Shrum, thank you very much. House member Nan Hayworth and Heather Higgins, we appreciate it. Coming out tonight.